Going to begin fittingly with Fox senior political analyst Brit Hume, who spent all day covering this story. You were on the set from 9:45 this morning until now. What was that experience like as someone who's watched a lot of Senate hearings?
Well, it was personally distressing to me that we even got to this point where we had to, where this squalid allegations came up, you know, after the matter was essentially closed. And he had to respond to it in such a way that he had to try to prove a negative, which is virtually impossible to do. And then, as I rather anticipated, came her testimony, which was emotional, as was his, and powerful in its way. And I thought to myself, now the burden is even higher on him. And the Republicans did next to nothing through the hired questioner they had to cast doubt on her testimony. And politically speaking, that might have been wise. So it all was up to him. And I was wondering whether he could do it and whether the mild-mannered young man, young compared to me, that he is, would be effective in this setting under these circumstances. I have to say, I think he was extremely effective. I think his emotion, at times he was near tears, made his testimony credible. If you're accused, Tucker, and you may know this, of something that wrong and it's false, it makes you emotional.
I do know that feeling very well.
Exactly. And I think that came through. So the audience here really comes down to a handful of Republican senators who are undecided, at least nominally undecided. It is a little hard to imagine after today's testimony by him that they would turn against him. Remember, these allegations against him were uncorroborated when the day began, and they were uncorroborated at the end of the day still. And the only corroborative evidence really that was produced were his old calendars and diaries that he produced. They're not dispositive, but they're something. And so it becomes down to his word against his, and seems to me at least as credible as she was. So I think, you know, at this point, it's utterly regrettable that we got here. The process has been damaged for years. Now it's ruined, and this is where we are. One hopes he may survive it.
The moment that shocked me the most, that I expected least, and I agree with you, I never thought a man like Brett Kavanaugh could do what he did today. I was stunned by it. But the moment that really shocked me was when he spoke about praying with his daughters for Christine Ford as a father. And what was your reaction
to
that?
Well, you know, this is what serious Christians do. This is what serious Christians are called to do, that you are to love your enemies and that you are to pray for those who may have harmed you. Now, I'm not saying Christine Blasey Ford was actually an enemy in that sense, but in this setting, of course she was. She was the one pitted against
him. She has harmed him.
Yes. She's harmed him, certainly. And, you know, that this is the kind of people. I don't know Brett Kavanaugh, but I know his father, so I know the family to some extent. I also know her father and that family to some extent. They're fine people, all of them. So that's one of the things that makes this thing so terribly sad. But
yes.
I think that was a moment. And then I think when Senator Lindsey Graham, who I think has been indignant about this for weeks now, got his turn, he wasn't having any questioning done by somebody else. He made as powerful a statement and denunciation of this process and what's happened to it as any I've ever heard from anybody in this town. I've been around here a long time.
That was an unbelievable moment. We're going to play clips from that in just a minute in case you missed it. That was a moment,
it was.
For sure. I will never forget that. Brit Hume, thank you very much.
You bet, Tucker.